At the John Lilly Correctional Facility in Boley, Oklahoma, they've come up with a novel idea to help boost inmate morale. They recently finished an in-house barbershop that will be staffed by the inmates. Steve Shaw made the trip to Ofuskee County and joins us now with that story. Steve.
Rich, 5 months ago, John Lilly's warden told me about this barbershop when we were down there for something else. He says many inmates already made terrible mistakes. There's no reason to make it worse.
And this is a big morale boost.
Yeah.
Barbershop.
Major morale
boost. Central Control
boost.
Was also a big morale boost.
It was.
Terry Tuggle completed his 39th year with the Oklahoma Department of Corrections 2 weeks ago. He's been the warden here at John Lilly in Boley since the pandemic. One thing Tuggle noticed early on was John Lilly's in-house barber service was woeful.
It's claustrophobic.
Yes, it is. That's my point. Very. You know, and so this is what we were working with, and I'm thinking, like, man, this is horrendous.
But you can see why guys didn't want to get their hair cut.
I can see. It became obvious when I first come in here. But it wasn't no pride in it. You didn't want to come.
Tuggle says it was a struggle to get some inmates to get their hair cut at all.
And then we had misuse. This is a facility, a penitentiary. You always would have that misuse part. But you know, for the most part, people just was not interested in it. I couldn't understand it. I could not understand, you know, from that side of it. You know, you gotta have a good barbershop.
The warden wanted to fix it. But John Lilly already had plans to replace the facility's central control building, which is the heartbeat of any prison. All of that physical labor, plumbing, construction, electrical work, and HVAC was completed by inmates here. The new central control building opened about 8 months ago. Then something else happened.
Some of the same guys that got the central control building going participated in getting the barbershop going.
Yep, matter of fact, they did. And I mean, when I said that was what amazing is because what they wanted to do, okay, they felt like they took great satisfaction in the new central control. Great satisfaction. Now, it was amazing because they took more satisfaction than getting that barbershop. And when you talk to them, they said, well, it was something that we wanted. That we wanted. And all they needed to have it was the go. You know, like, let them have it. Let them do it. So that's, to me, what's so special. The most special thing about the barbershop is something that they did for themselves.
John Lilly Recreation Director Cody Lee supervised the barbershop project.
You know, you can't see what this room used to look like, so knowing what it used to look like and being here sitting in the chair today is just a big testament to the craftsmanship that went into it.
Done by inmates in this facility.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, they did the plumbing, the electrical, the HVAC, the drywall. Every screw, every nail, every coat of paint, every single tile laid. They, you know, hand finished all the wood. So, you know, you name it, they've done it.
All you need in here is a TV.
Yes. Yeah, we're actually in the process of getting that. So we're gonna mount it right up here.
Something else that's great for morale is all these haircuts for the inmates are free. Now, staff pays a buck a cut.
Good morning, fellas.
Good morning, Warden. How you doing?
All right.
The new barbershop is staffed completely by inmates.
How long have you been here?
4 years.
Can you give me a sense kind of what you're in here for?
Making bad choices out there, and it led me here. But this is my first time in and my last time in. You won't see me back in here, that's for sure.
How long you been cutting hair?
I've been cutting hair since high school. So that's telling my age, I guess. That's about 20-some years I've been out of high school now.
Is this something maybe you can do when you get back out on the outside?
Yeah, my goal is to do like 10 heads a day and charging $10 because a regular haircut in the world is like $35, $40. So
69-year-old John Fields has been incarcerated for a year and cuts hair just about every day.
You know, this is good for you too, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
What does it do for you?
It gives me a sense of accomplishment because I take something and make it look better.
And these guys want the help.
There's a lot of guys on the yard that need good haircuts.
And there's some good discussions, I'm sure, that go on in this room that's very productive.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Very, very productive. Good things.
It's a blessing. It really is. With everything that goes on in the world.
What do you plan to do when you get out?
I plan on continuing to be retired. I spent 40 years and 9 months with the Department of Defense before I got incarcerated. So, like I said, I was retired, and so I'm going to go back to being retired and then chasing grandkids.
Robert Scallion's been inside for 4 years.
You know, there's some camaraderie that's built into this, isn't there?
It is. All these guys, good guys, excellent guys. I like talking to them, being around them, coming in the barbershop and just shooting the junk.
And the price is right.
And the price is right.
Jack Barnett's been in prison for 21 years for assault with intent. He's also one of the inmates who helped build John Lilly's new central control building and the barbershop. He gets out soon.
We did a bunch of demo, and then once we got the demo done, we went in there and we put a barbershop together.
It's slick.
Well, I mean, it did turn out real nice.
How much does this do for you? You're getting out in 30 days after 21 years. This has got to give you momentum going forward.
Yes, I was a carpenter before I came in, and I thought I'd lost all those skills and kind of forgot who I was. So having a chance to do all this and hone my skills up has really been good for me. It's been a godsend. This maintenance department over here has let me have a second look at all the things I used to do, and I'm real thankful for it.
Warden Tuggle says he'd like to eventually add a few more chairs, more space, and even start a small barber school here at John Lilly.
I sit there and I watch all these talented people. They're coming in there, they cut hair, they're good at it, but they don't have a license. They're just good at it. Wouldn't it be great to get a license behind being good, especially when you're as good as you are?
You know, they made their mistake. They're here to, you know, rehabilitate. In order to, you know, hopefully progress in their life. And so we don't try to make it any harder than it has to be. So any stress that we can alleviate on them by being able to, you know, maybe create a real world scenario here for them to be able to feel like they're not just stuck where they are, really helps with the morale in the yard.
Warden Tuggle says the barbershop was built with materials left over from the central control building construction. And the inmates performed all the labor. And I got to tell you this, Career Tech, Oklahoma Career Tech, they played a big role in this as well.